Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanakwa, the second coming of Jesus. The parables and all this New Testament is on my fingertips. I have rendered all the exposition, and more you preach, more you our Father will give you. So if you keep your mouth shut, you will get nothing. Whatever is given to you is taken away, and that knowledge will kill you because you haven't used it for your own safety. This is the gospel is the safest weapon that you can use to repulse sons of the Satan. So the sons of Satan who are killing in the Middle East now, where they are killing people under the name of Christian and Muslim. Here is the Acts of Apostles 12, verse 25 to onward. Then after completing their mission, Barnabas and Saul returned to Jerusalem and brought with them John, whose other name was Mark. Now in the church at Antioch, there were prophets and teachers. Now you remember that after John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16, there are no prophets. So these prophets and teachers are not required in the church, because church is the where the we ponder over his word, which is by thinking logically. So there's a corruption, you know. In the church, the royal priest are the people who are resident. The royal priest roam around from one church to the other. They are wanderer. But the people who are staying in the church and they come and ponder over his word, they are secular people with family they are living. And they are the one who tell their children the moral laws and everything. So Barnabas Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, a member of the court of Herod, the ruler, and Saul, when they were worshipping our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, ParBrahm, etc., and not the Lord Yahweh, in which you fast and say prayers. This is a corruption, you know, by the Messianic Jews. As we do not pray, but ponder over his word in our hearts to preach gospel from our own hearts and not the dead books, the Holy Spirits, not the dead books. You know, that's why Jesus said, when you go out to preach gospel, don't take two shoes. Don't take money in your pocket and no script, no Bible in your hand. And you shall be able to preach gospel from your heart. That is what it is. The Holy Spirit set apart for me Barnabas and Saul because they had become efficient in preaching gospel from their heart for the work to which I have called them. That is, they became spiritually advanced, ready to leave the secular world for wilderness to bear 100% fruit. Remember the parable of the sower? Some seed fell on the flat ground, on the rocky soil and other. So the wilderness is the soil free of the weeds, no secular work involved. Then after fasting and praying, which is again corruption, you know, this is a, they laid their hands on them and sent them off. they don't need to lay their hand, because the person who is devoting himself to preaching, he does it of his own free will. He doesn't need your praises. He doesn't need laying your hands and other thing. Our Father's hand is on him. Our Father God's hand is on him. So you don't need, he doesn't need man's hand, praises of men, as they do in churches. You know, they send somebody to Africa or another place, they lay hand on him, you know, this and that. Then he is always thinking of them who laid hand on him, you know, not of our Father God. So being sent out by the Holy Spirit, they went down to Seleucia. And from there they sailed to Cyprus. They became preachers of gospel. The sowers, some seed fell on flat ground and rocky soil. They preached like a sower. When they arrived at Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in the synagogues of the Jews. Jews are the sick people, spiritually sick people. They need gospel more than anyone else. And they had John also to assist them. When they had gone through the whole island as far as Paphos, they met a certain magician, a Jewish false prophet named Bar Jesus. He was with the proconsul Sergius Paulus, an intelligent man who summoned Barnabas and Saul and wanted to hear the word of God. So he was an intelligent man, you know, because he was seeking his word. So that's why he asked for Barnabas and Saul. Remember that we don't throw pearls before swine. A person who seeks, he goes to them. But Barnabas and Saul went to him, you know, because he wanted to have, he had an interest in gospel. They were eager to preach and wanted to hear the word of God. But the magician, Elymas, for that is the translation of his name, opposed them, because he was thinking, you know, being a psychic, you know, the psychic person, he, sometimes I meet psychic people, I tell them this gospel, and they say things which are quite stupid, you know, and they want to make me to believe that one. So these psychic, you know, they say, they try to misguide you. They don't want to lose their position because they are in favor of those people. People love them because they are psychic. They know how to manipulate the people, as the politicians are psychic. Politicians love the stupid people who render them the praises. So this magician is like this politician of today. He wanted false praises, opposed them and tried to turn the proconsul away from the faith. So he just intervened. He won't let them speak, you know, he will come and put his own mouth. But Saul, also known as Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked intently at him and said, "You son of devil, a psychic, who wants to control the people for his own praises, you enemy of all righteousness." Like these politicians are psychic, they don't want righteousness. They want what pleases people. Full of all deceit and villainy, will you not stop making crooked the straight logical paths of our supernatural Father Elohim and not the Lord Yahweh? Jewish people put this word Lord. We have no Lord in the royal kingdom of God. God is our Father, Holy Spirit is our Mother, and we are the sons of the Most High. We represent them. And now listen, the hand of the Elohim and not the Lord is against you. And you will be blind for a while, unable to see the sun. Sun means our Father God, primary source of light. You won't understand gospel. You will be spiritually blind. And that is given to him in making him physically blind to know the blindness into which he is leading the people. Immediately mist and darkness came over him, and he went about groping for someone to lead him by the hand. When the proconsul saw what had happened, he believed, for he was astonished at the preaching of gospel and not teaching of the dead letters from the books about the Elohim and not the Lord Yahweh. Gospel is of Elohim and the dead letters are of Yahweh. Dead letters, the moral laws are of Yahweh. So Jesus came to fulfill the Yahweh's dead letter, which was missing with the oral Torah, his word. So Jesus came to fulfill the law and not to destroy them. So this is the gospel of our Father God, and our Father God blesses you.